What if dragons really did exist? How would that have changed the face of ancient warfare? In this class at Georgia Tech, modeling, simulation, and military gaming, we bring in students and we put them into interdisciplinary teams, and then they really spend the entire semester developing a simulation of a historical battle to try to answer a specific research question. For this particular model, the students started with the same type of model of a historical battle that they would normally have done, and then they added in this element of the dragon.
We picked the Battle of Cannae because it's sort of symbolic of maybe a generic medieval kind of battle, which is what we assumed we'd be kind of putting a dragon into. And then with Hannibal also using elephants to cross the Alps, we assumed that if he had a dragon, he would take full advantage of that.
Historically, Carthage demolished Rome in this battle. And the program is called NetLogo. It's a very simple program as far as visual aspects. You have different agents and different patches. So an agent is like something that's there that spawns, like a person or a dragon. And then your patches are like the landscape.
The way we programmed the dragon to move, we sort of got from a model of how birds flock. So it's kind of imitating what we thought would be a reasonable dragon movement.
Chandler created a model for the dragon, and it flies over and it spawns fire agents. And the fire agents, if the troops are within a certain range of this fire agent as it spawns, it'll spawn a fire agent, and then the fire agent will cause damage to anybody that's in a certain radius.
In the show, the dragons kind of fight for one side. They kind of know what side they fight for, but there's also sort of the effect of if there's fire on the ground, then that's obviously going to affect everybody.
They have this morale factor where they're less effective in battle, because they're obviously, if you see a dragon flying over and spraying fire, you're going to be scared. You're not going to be fighting as effectively. Let's say Rome has a dragon and Carthage doesn't. Obviously, whoever has a dragon wins the fight. I think that's pretty obvious. But what was interesting is about 70% of the casualties were caused by the dragon.
It's certainly a game changer. I think you don't need to spend as much time thinking about strategy if you have something so overpowering. In current military terms, a dragon we think would probably be pretty equivalent to like using helicopter with napalm in Vietnam, because it's dropping fire. And depending on, I guess, how tough the dragon scales were, it's maybe equivalent to like metal.
Military simulations aren't as creative because you're adhering to historical standards. With the dragon, you can be a lot more creative in how you implement that.
I think that's part of the fun of it, is the ridiculousness of it and the opportunity to be creative with it. I mean, I think it says a lot about sort of the diversity at Tech and sort of the things that the students are working on. It's not an experience I was hoping I would have, but I hope future work is as fun as putting a dragon into a historic battle.